But this time around, about the issue of taxing the profits that telcos make on mobile money, here's caution against any decision to tax profits by telcos on mobile money transactions.
In the view of the Communications Minister, Esla Osuo-Kufo, the 71 million cedis generated by the telcos in transaction fees on mobile money ought to be taxed by the state.
What I have been advocating, and I'll continue to advocate for it, is that the revenue that the companies earn from the transaction fees that you and I pay, they're earning upwards in the region of about 80 million cedis every month, and they are paying nothing. Any company that operates and earns revenue in this country is required by law to pay taxes on it. So I'm urging GRA to sit down with them and work out some arrangement by which government can also derive its fair share.
But financial analyst Joe Jackson cautions government on that move.
The profits that the telcos make, they are paying corporate tax. It's not like they don't pay any tax at all. Mm. So if she's talking about charging them extra tax, then it is something over and above what regular corporates pay, and that is the question we should be asking. Mm. Remember, mobile money has been of extreme value to this country. What's left? There's extra tax when I talk. There's extra tax when I do Facebook. Now, mobile money too small. Please don't go there.
He wants the Communications Ministry to stay away from pushing an idea which will increase the tax burden on Ghanaians, since the telcos will pass on the tax to consumers.
If you start to tax them, how is that tax going to feed back to us as mobile money users? Mm-hmm. And remember that mobile money, the heaviest use of mobile money, is at the bottom of the pyramid.